Chalk Talk, Episode 1. I'm your host, Jerry Shepard, and today I want to talk about insect foggers and how German roaches survive. Traditionally, when we think about fogging, filling the air with insecticide, we think that German roaches, or any insect for that matter, has no room to escape. There are several different types of foggers on the market, and we use them all in many places, our attics, our rooms, our crawl spaces, even our campers and our cars. But in so many cases, all we're left with is a mess to clean up, and we still have live bugs. The other problem with foggers is you've got to leave for about 4 hours in most cases, so have some place to go. Foggers take a lot of work. You've got to think about your birds, your pets, your food, your fish tanks, cleaning up, and it's a lot of work. Foggers also can be dangerous. Too many in a small room or open flames can be a real problem, and we can do better than that. Every year, there are 550 reported accidents, fires, or even explosions due to insect bombs. People tend to overuse many pesticides, and foggers are no exception. If the label calls for one fogger for a 9x12 room and extinguish all the pilot lights, let's do that. Let's do what the label says. It means what it says, and it says what it means. Don't be number 551. Don't be a statistic. German roaches can detect everything, including airborne pesticides, and that's what a fogger is. They're very good at figuring out danger, and we've tried everything over mankind's history, traps, baits, and sprays, but they still come back. German roaches are about 350 million years old, and they've adapted over all these years with many, many dangers. So a fogger, insect fogger filling the air is just one more thing that they pretty much figured out how to get away from and how to survive. So if you're going to use a fogger, do everything correctly, clean up, get everything right, and hope for the best. But foggers generally just aren't the best. And part of that reason is their antenna can pick up the airborne minuscule chemical particles before it ever has a chance to really harm them. When they do detect the fog misting down upon them, they simply run for cover under a stove, under a refrigerator, a crack or a crevice. And those that are already sort of hiding or back in a crevice and they sense the fog, simply go a little deeper and wait for the air to be cleared. Foggers also are at the mercy of air currents, and they don't penetrate very well. You can have all your drawers open, the cabinets open, and set off a bomb and it goes straight up in the air, but it's not going to get back in the underneath the sink or the back of the drawer where a nest of roaches may be. They'll just live to fight another day. And of course, if you're really messy, that's super easy for a roach to avoid the insecticide and real easy for him to get away from that. Now, foggers do kill roaches, and you could get some real satisfaction of cleaning up a couple of dustpans full after a successful fogging, or what you think is successful. But the roaches that survive may take a while, but they're going to resume their normal activity, and they will be back. Hey, thanks for watching. Please visit us at www.pestcemetery.com for any further information. We have a lot of articles there, and one feature is askthebugdoctor.com, where you could upload a picture, ask a question, and I respond to everybody and happy to do it. And remember, at pestcemetery.com, our motto is, finally, a place for pests to rest.